kibble. He's got to be here somewhere. Shit! Shut up!
Right, this is now.
Bagley, update. Let's just say I'm both impressed and annoyed by how sophisticated this anti-tamper security is. Still working.
Bagley, tell me you're close.
I'm through security. Now wading through terabytes of decoy code looking for the detonation sequence. Dalton, I need your physical appendages now.
What's wrong?
There are three slots on the left. One of them is the receiver. You need to pull the controller wire.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm fucking not. Pull the wire.
If this gets me blown up...
Diffused.
See? That wasn't so bad, was it?
Bagley, you bastard. You're gonna get me a bloody heart attack then. Whoa, what the fuck am I looking at?
It appears Parliament is not the only target.
More bombs are going live as we speak.
On screen, Bagley.
Fucking hell, we need to get the word out. Those sites need to be evacuated.
They're spread out all over London. There isn't any time.
But my sister's at the Tone Conference. We have to do something.
I picked up a transmitter on the roof that is sending out a signal to the other bomb sites. If you can reach it...
I can shut it all down. Sabine!
Fuck! Dalton, we're breached! Go! The roof!
Sabine, what's going on?
We're being raided. It's a bloodbath. A protocol is to wipe everything, including Bagley.
I need him for the transmitter.
I know. But if they get him, they get everything. Names, ops, locations.
Okay. I'll do it the old-fashioned way. Wipe him.
Yes, wipe me.
Do it, Sabine, and get the hell out of there.
Fuck.
Okay. Bagley's down. You're on your own. Dalton, this goes.
It won't. I'll see you at the rally point. I promise.
Good luck.
can't do this myself.
That's where they were. Check it.
With some important work.
Important work? Killing thousands of people.
Exactly. To save the world. You do know Londoners have died before, hmm? The plague, the Great Fire, the Blitz. There's not much fun. But destruction is always the cure. And it begins today. Zero day. Time for a hard reset.
Oh my God.
A series of explosions devastated three sites in London. Authorities are asking residents to remain in their homes as the situation continues to develop. We have received no official casualty total, but it is expected.
Mourners gathered for a series of candlelight vigils that brought closure to thousands of families and indeed to an entire city. London is now laser-focused.
They attend Downing Street, where Nigel Cass, CEO of private military company Albion, received a mandate to secure London. Cass has vowed to hunt down DedSec. Intelligence systems and autonomous drones to capture the remaining members of DedSec. A stark warning to would-be insurgents.
Corporations are posting record profits due to increased efficiencies in production and distribution, enabled by the use of technologies initially developed and approved for security purposes.
Crime numbers take a dive. Illegal gambling, drug trafficking and prostitution all down following prosecutions of the leaders of four of London's five largest criminal syndicates. The streets of Camden and Brixton.
As Albion's mandate is extended indefinitely by the government, life finally begins to return to normal. Curfews and travel restrictions have been lifted in all boroughs thanks to the
reports of rioting in Trafalgar Square have been greatly exaggerated, possibly by foreign meddlers pushing a false narrative through social media. Albion is in complete control of the
public about circulation of fake news, conspiracy theories persisting in dark corners of the internet that terrorist group DedSec were framed for the bombings have been roundly rejected. Our own reporters could not find a single Londoner willing to expound those theories on camera. The facts. Another story.
I need to assemble a team, but I can't reboot DedSec alone. Let me break into London CTOS and see who's available.
I'm Claire Waters, and we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I say they should all be lined up and shut.
You don't find it awfully convenient that they've been fingered as the attackers, but we've seen no proof?
Look at Tone! Look at our city! What more proof do you need?
Well, Colin, I'd say you have to look at their history of non-violent action. Albion's put more civilians in the hospital in the past few months than DedSec ever has. I smell a scapegoat. Now I have Emily calling in. Emily, what's your take?
You're absolutely right, Claire.
Oh. I don't think I should have done that.
But there's a candidate. Looks like you're DedSec's best hope.
Why not? Fuck the CTOS. Welcome.
glad to see you're alive. If you're still committed to the cause, DedSec needs you. Okay, I'll send you the coordinates to our last safe house. Meet me there.
All right.
Whoa.
This is London Road. You're listening to Buckingham. Your source for what they don't
need. These roads don't make any sense.
It's hard to believe that there could be shortages.
Can I go this way or no?
In an advanced country like ours. And yet, here we are. Those old government promises of adequate food turn out to be just another lie. Today we're short of basic foodstuffs and vital minerals of blood. Hundreds have already died of conditions that could be easily cured. The black market means that criminal gangs like Clan Kelly run our cities. And Prime Minister
Dennis is around to pretend to care.
How do we go from a consumer paradise to a place of
empty
shells
and fight
for the blood?
Don't even dare
what
honk
turns land plenty into a wild west of hoarding, food battles and black market barons? We protect everyone who comes on the podcast by keeping their identities. Here's veteran political reporter Ian on the power behind shortages.
I mean, what's the first thing happened when Britain sealed itself off?
Auto drive now enabled.
Stopped from coming in was fresh food. I mean, we could live without the fresh food. I mean, everyone's quality of life got instantly worse when we could live without it. The most damaging part was when the radioactive isotopes stopped coming in. Now, radioactive isotopes, that's what we use in cancer screening, cancer treatment. Now, that stuff, it has a short half-life. Technique,
interesting. You can't even do it. Oh, there's that person. Yeah, I've seen all those people.
I've downloaded a patch to your optics so you can access our security system. It's set up so that I can't just let someone who isn't DedSec in. You will have to do the manual override.
Very well. This manual override will be like putty in my hands. Oh, here we go. Down the rabbit hole. Hello? Anyone home? Ah, I suppose I should turn the power back on.
Registration detected. Identify yourself, or I'll seal the exits, hack your optic, and read you every drunken email you ever wrote until you starve.
Oh, do simmer down. Sabine brought me here.
Sabine's alive? Well, that's one piece of good news. I'm Bagley, DedSec's definitely not stolen, highly advanced AI assistant, and it seems I've been out of commission for a few months. Anyway, why don't you go connect me to the Dead Set network so I can become more powerful than you could possibly imagine? I mean, catch up on what I missed. It. I'm reconnected to the network, downloading our database, news archives, and oh no. Terrorist group DedSec responsible for deadly bombings in London. Dalton Wolf dead? I leave you people alone for a second and you immediately cock it all up.
So, since DedSec did not perpetrate the bombings, the question is, who did?
There's a gap in my memory after Dalton, well, let's be honest, after I... I'm missing information about what happened after I was taken offline, but from what I can infer, an unknown hacker group identified only as Zero Day was involved. I believe this Zero Day staged the attacks and framed DedSec for their dirty work. Come to my terminal. Sabine is requesting a video call.
And we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown him in jail. Now...
Hello, everybody.
Patching in Sabine Brandt now. I suggest you listen very closely to anything she has to say.
There you are. I'm glad you made it. Packley. God, it's good to hear your demented little voice. Is your memory intact?
Not even slightly. The last record I have is of our HQ being raided. My only lead is a group known as Zero Day. Ring any bells?
No. But the HQ was attacked by some men in black, the same that were at Parliament. Maybe working together. We didn't stand a chance. They just gunned everyone down.
Dreadful business. How did you make it out alive?
I managed to escape through the sewers to Camden. A contact smuggled me out of the city, and I've been hiding out in the north since.
Prudent. Your profile is red flagged as a high priority target in the city surveillance system. Even a partial recognition here would have you hunted down and shot on sight.
The city's out for DedSec's blood, I'm afraid. I wish I could help, but I'd be sticking my neck out. And I quite like my neck.
Listen, if anyone knows anything about risks, it's me. I lost everything and everyone. But it comes down to this. London is in a death spiral. And if DedSec can't pull it out, trust me, no one can. The city needs a resistance. And it starts with you.
I can't.
What do you say?
I suppose we'd... better get started, then.
Excellent. New user registered. Welcome to DedSec. Now, it would be irresponsible of us to release you naked and mewling into the wild. You'll find equipment around the safe house that are essential items in your DedSec kit. have a sophisticated system for hiding your identity from facial recognition tech. It's called a mask. And while we're here, perhaps we can talk about updating your wardrobe. I mean, look at you. Come on.
See if we can get a whole outfit going here. Wait, no. There we are. Okay, shop.
You've got all these fancy new toys, but it's also important to know the basics. You need to learn how to throw a punch and how to take one. Albion will escalate if you come at them with a gun and shoot you down. We want to avoid collateral damage. In DedSec, we try to use guns only as a last resort.
Have you already met Connie Robinson? She owns the pub and is an old DedSec contact, not to mention a champion amateur boxer. Go to the practice ring and she'll show you how to stop flinching when someone cocks a punch at you.
Meh. Sure, why not? What's going on, people? Hello, everyone.
I'll be right down. Could you use the warm up?
Let's start with some basic strikes. Hit me. Don't be shy. Getting it. Just like that. You want to get in under my block. Find the weak point. Yes. Nice one. Yes. Nice one. Quick on your feet now. You want to create distance. That's it.
Oh, God. That's right. Oh, that's it.
Gear in order? Know enough not to punch yourself in the face or get shot for pulling out a gun too early? Brilliant. I'm working out how we find Zero Day and ruin their day, but I need someone with actual legs to do the legwork. Hope you're ready.
We have some damage control to do if we want to change the perception that we're a bunch of violent thugs. I'll let you be the judge of how best to handle yourself, but remember, you represent DedSec now.
What the hell is that? Huh. That's random. All random. Okay, let's grab these. Can't grab those. What the hell? Whatever.
First things first. What comes first?
Make no mistake, London is under occupation. Armed mercenaries patrol our streets, allegedly to keep people safe, but really they're keeping the people scared.
Nothing like fear to keep people in line. Albion can get away with just about anything.
So, we have to ignite the will to resist in the people of London by showing them that Albion aren't the solution. They're the problem.
For that, we'll need information. I'm pushing two sets of coordinates to your optic.
Cheers, Bagley. I've identified two opportunities. One, we're going to disrupt some Albion propaganda. Remind the people it's not Albion's way or the highway. Two, We need intel about Albion operations if we want to throw a spanner in their plans. You game?
I am game, set and match, my dear.
Brilliant. Let's get the people of London on board.
Getting arsehole and throwing bits of metal around has got to count as training somehow.
You look like the rebellious sort. Are you interested in fighting the good fight?
Are you dead sick or something?
A gentleman never reveals his secrets.
Perhaps you can help me against some pricks working for Clan Kelly.
Keep talking.
Right then. Some cocknocker gangsters have been putting a squeeze on old folks and shopkeeps for protection money. I'll be scamming the fucking book. Here's the thing. I've got this crypto hack that can get their dosh back for them. I just need the private key.
And I suppose you could use our help in finding this key.
That's right. Get me the key and everything these pricks stole will get stolen back. Listen, help me with this and I'll return the favor. I always do.
All right. My friends and I will see what's what.
Acquire. Destruct. Should I try? Can I get in it? Whoa. Damn. This thing's a beast.
Well, would you look at all this? You can't turn your head without seeing some Albion imagery. You really can't get away from them.
There's going to be that much less once you're done here. Let's give Camden a break from these eyesores.
Of course. Easy peasy.
If you hijacked that scissor lift, you could use it to access the rooftop.
Yes, nicely done. That'll get people's attention. Let them know someone is standing up to Albion. Light the spark that they can stand up to.
If nothing else, it'll relieve their eye strain.
Now what?
You need to steal information about Albion's plans. That'll give us what we need to really put the hurt on their operations.
On the cart. Jesus Christ, bud. What's wrong with this guy? Idiot drivers, I swear. What the hell is this? I have too much fun with this shit. Yikes. Holy shit. Yeah, you go get him, officer. Enemies with anybody.
Let's find this wanker. search.
Stupid drone!
Albion personnel are equipped to resolve any situation.
Fuck off, drone!
Look for the breach! Someone's inside! Drone, we're on search.
That's weird.
This is stupid.
That's weird.
Fuck!
That's fine.
Someone attacking me.
War between criminals and security that seems to dominate what's going on out there on the streets.
Auto drive now enabled.
Nothing shakes people's faces. Quite as much as when capitalism fails to deliver. Here's underground writer and analyst Alfie, the politics of property.
think what we've come to now is a realization that capitalism has essentially failed. I mean, the one key promise of capitalism that it makes to its citizens is that there will be surplus, that we will have plenty, and that's the whole logic for running society in this way, that people will have enough. And now, with these kind of huge shortages of everything, you're seeing that system collapse. It hasn't delivered on its primary promise. And I think we've really reached the situation where we have to do away with capitalism entirely. We're seeing a situation where there's shortages for the many, but for a few individuals, there's an elite who are not struggling and short of anything. So this is kind of fundamental inequality of a capitalist system, which is no longer producing the goods for most of us. Shortages are being used as well. I'm not saying that they're not. There isn't a real shortage. There possibly is real shortages, but also shortages are being used.
I'm not good for the rest of the fucking week. So there's simply not enough to go around as the justification for maintaining the kind of power of the 1% and leaving the rest of the school.
Albion have established an operational base in the Royal Court of Justice.
Lovely. So Albion has the power to detain anyone they want, and they hold enough sway over the courts to make fair trials a thing of the past.
Exactly. But it likely means there's information here about how Albion are targeting dissenters, the who and the why. We need that data if we're going to disrupt their operation.
Amazing. Yeah, that's at home.
seeing anything here. Moving elsewhere. Area's clear. Continuing the search.
Tell me what we've got, Bags.
A list of what... Albion consider high-value targets that are threats to the peaceful running of London. See here, a journalist, and this one runs a community shelter. Good God, bar your doors.
What the hell?
All suspected of sowing rebellion or exhibiting tendencies towards... Albion is systematically arresting people even before they rise up. Joke's on them. This list can actually help us find like-minded allies willing to help us. Well done.
Vehicle acting up. Shut it down.
We're already seeing results from what you've done. That list we found named a journalist in Camden who's been investigating Albion. We reached out and he's got information that can help us. I think you should meet with him.
Drop a pin on the map for me, would you?
Scenes. It's worth remembering that the telecoms tower is now owned by Blue. The tower looms
over. Auto drive now enabled.
Northwest.
That is completely okay. I will respect your boundaries. Boundaries.
London, it's always been a communications hub, acting as part of the UK's television and communications network. Although, there's been some secrecy around its use, and now that Bloom owns it, it's only even more secret.
Yet now everything that's part of Bloom's city surveillance operation is run through the telecoms tower. And I have to say, it looks completely ridiculous. It's got that silly crown thing at the top and all the blue light.
What's that even about? What does it do? I don't see that there's any purpose to that at all.
It's a blight on the skyline, if you ask me. And it's become the main point of control for millions of people.
I really do.
The system network and Bagley are both operated and streamed from there too.
And don't forget about the self-driving cars too.
I always thought they were just running on their own.
No, CTOS is the big control system behind the cars. There was a point back in the earliest days of self-driving car technology that they operated by themselves. They used to use a series of sensors to see the world around them. Radar, for instance, would look far off into the distance, while LiDAR would detect objects nearby. And while these cars still use some of this technology, Bloom's CTOS and its detailed maps and data that it has on London really makes Bloom be able to take control of it. And CTOS can take control of your car if you're incorrectly. It's no surprise that it was made mandatory to have a self-driving car.
The system is so bad, though. It's so annoying. Whenever I try to use one of the shareable self-driving cars, I always find myself stuck in traffic jams or roadblocks. Not to mention the accidents. I've heard so many stories of cars shunting into the back of others. I think they're worse than human drivers sometimes.
The technology was meant to make things better, but Bloom has made it so bad that it just makes London even more chaotic than it was before. I'm giving up on the cars. I'm only using the bikes, which are not self-driving, at the moment at least. And don't even get me started on the data. Everything that Bloom sees from your movements around the city and the self-driving cars is collected and feeds back into its big information control system.
Oh, not you and Bloom and privacy again. You're a broken record.
Not as broken as our city's cars.
Buccaneer, this is the bug. Hello, resistors, it's bug time. Are you all sitting comfortably? No? Good, that's as it should be. This is the bug. I'm Andy, and joining me to analyse the latest blowflies to emerge from the cook for once in Britain, it's Alice.
Hello, Andy.
And today, we're going to talk to you about Albion, your friend and mine. Alice, the government has extended Albion's contract and has also boasted that violent crime has plummeted to a record low.
Auto-drive.
Now,
extending Albion's contract. For me, that's not having a pet day.
Heard you need a hand. How can I help?
Your recruit has been sticking it to Albion. Can't believe someone else is. Thought I was alone, right? Not doing much, just putting the word out. But you? Taking action, mate.
It's our duty, love. If we don't fight back, Albion will accumulate more and more power, and we can't have that now, can we? So, let's talk.
Almost got clipped finding this. All of Albion's operational data for the entire city. Convoy routes, surveillance targets, assets, it's all there. Thinking you can make good use of that.
Well, I'm pleased as punch.
Here's a sample. Albion's closed King's Cross to the public, right? What people don't know is that they're using it as their logistics centre, materials, troops, whatever. A lot of it runs through there. You want to give the people a huge boost? Hit that place. Put it out of commission, and you'll severely hamstring Albion's operations here in Camden. Hell, everywhere.
The next step's clear, then.
Albion's operational plans are just what we needed to really get some traction. We'll have to take a close look at this. Now, how do we take King's Cross offline?
Albion's housed a massive hybrid power generator in there. Output must... getting to that generator ain't going to be easy. They've locked it up tighter since I last saw.
Anyone have a suggestion?
My news drones are still in here. They should be functional. You can use one of them. Probably have better luck piloting it too, yeah?
Causing a power surge in a hybrid power generator isn't like making a toasty. We're going to need detailed specifications.
Best look into it. Take a look at this.
Cool, looks bloody complicated. Newsy's got a pretty functional camera. Would a picture do you, Bagley?
It would indeed. According to this, there's an override code that'll get us into the generator's system. That's it. Use the code on the generator and I can trigger a power surge.
It should be enough to take King's Cross offline. And the rail system too. Here we go.
We got a gold mine of information out of St. Pancras. Albion convoys, informants, gear, you name it. Everything we need to ignite the people of London, like we did in Camden. Derail Albion's operations and give the people a reason to rise up, borough by borough. The more we do that, the more we'll get allies flocking to the cause. We'll show London that DedSec is here for them.
That was off the chain, mate. I knew DedSec weren't the bad guys Albion was saying. Now the rest of Camden will too. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Now that you've shown the borough what DedSec is really all about, there are going to be folks wanting to join up. A lot of people have been looking for a way to fight back. In fact, there's one in particular I suspect will contact you very soon. I happen to know they're champion at the bit.
We'll be glad to have them. It'll take all sorts to spank London back to normal.
This is good.
she would just take me. And accept me for who I am. I've actually changed quite a bit.
Hooray! Another friend to raise hell with. Welcome to DedSec.
I'm ready to stir up the shit with you.
Fabulous.
Guys, no missions.
Sorry, you've missed him. I'm afraid he's popped out for the decade.
Oh, never mind. Is there anyone else I can talk to?
Yes, of course. There's a shady cabal of vested interests who control him and prop him up in power.
Great, I'll have a chat with them then.
Oh, and you remember when you could get away with prank calls without people coming around to your house to beat the shit out of you?
Oh, happy times.
You're listening to the...
Did you think the Prime Minister will ever come back?
I don't think we've ever had a Prime Minister.
Well, that's a much more reassuring way of looking at things. What have we become? Alice, when you look at the state of our politics, we're supposed to have the mother of parliaments. Well, this is one mother that has emphatically abandoned her kids in the woods to be brought up by wolves. And let me tell you, that never works out like it does in the stories. Wolves are bad parents. Unless you're a wolf, in which case they can do a job bringing you up as a wolf. Do not give your children to wolves. Do we actually own anything as a country now? Is there anything we haven't flogged off for profit? Oh, I think we've basically just become a homeopathic critic. Diluted and diluted until there's barely a trace of
the... I don't have a flat tire.
It's a quackish lunatic who says it actually works better that way. It's total bullshit. Is there anything left?
We're there!
New on the bug this week. A new feature. The bug.
Give back the people their damn jobs! Stop!
Okay, I'm here.
In theory, the AR reconstruction should allow me to use various sources of surveillance data to rebuild past events. Access a data relay, and I can scrape all the metadata for this area. That's it. Now, let's take this autocratic wet dream for a test drive.
CTOS AR, data reconstruction in progress.
Well, look at this.
You're right. We definitely need this extremely cool thing I want for investigating Zero Day. Shit, for some reason I can't clone it to our servers. All right, access the network here, and let's see if we can't find out where to nick one. Located the CTOS hub. Aha! The SIRS has deployed this technology at their HQ, and I've just nabbed their manual on how to set up the system. Now, Scarpa, you can't steal their toy if they throw you in the gulag.
Bagley, how do we get this magic AR machine?
The program is hosted on a server that's on the roof of SIRS HQ. All you have to do is grab the whole thing, then take it to a few high-density locations so I could recalibrate it. The Denset network, and clone my own version.
How am I supposed to get to the roof, Bagley? I'm not a bird. I can't fly.
We need to find someone with access to a cargo or construction drone that can fly it off of there. Perfect opportunity to recruit a heavy lifter to the cause, I'd say.
Bagley, where can I find this heavy lifter person?
Well, let's put our thinking caps on, shall we? Now, who in London would have access to a construction drone? Could it be a construction worker?
No shit, Mr. Bagley.
Not so hard, was it? There's an active construction yard nearby. I dare say you'll probably be able to find a construction worker to recruit there. Here's the coordinates.
On mobile.
Auto drive now enabled.
The bird. Objective voice of objection for a most objectionable world. Hello, bugsters. Welcome to The Bug, the comedy show that holds up the Medusa of satire to the already immovably concrete face of modern Britain. I'm Andy. I bench 480, and I can crack a tree in half just by looking at it. Can I? Well, what is reality anymore? Anyway. Alice, what do you bench?
I bench body weight.
Right.
Well, not my body weight. Okay. Body weight of a baby.
Auto drive now disabled.
Yeah, I mean, you don't need to get back on a Dita. Just
auto drive now enabled.
Where did you get that baby?
You are listening to The Bug.
In this week's Truth News, according to an official poll, 98% of Londoners are very happy with CTOS. Auto drive now enabled.
I'm not sure that I agree with this, Andy. I don't think 98% of Londoners have ever in the history of London ever agreed on anything.
Occupation? Check. Drone? Check. This could be the one.
They look promising.
Oh, they have a beastly drone friend. I mean, the person looks efficient too.
You look like trouble. You like to fight for freedom?
Are you saying you're dead sick? I could really use your help.
Why don't you say what the problem is first? Then we see.
Well, I'm fucking stupid is the main thing. I had a medical issue that, of course, our completely gutted NHS doesn't cover. So I went to Clan Kelly and, long story short, now I'm a slave. Do me a solid and free me.
Okay, we will take care of this for you.
Clan Kelly will bleed our new friend dry if we don't do something. This particular construction site is a money laundering front for a Kelly chapter out of Camden Market. Any record of the debt would be stored there.
Yes, I understand.
Sounds Russian.
I trust those folks. As much as I would trust Mary Kelly.
Kelly, if she came up to me and said, "Congratulations, Andy, you took on a free holiday to the south of France in the back of this windowless van."
I think official polls are like the unsolicited...
Auto drive now enabled.
...provides us. I didn't ask for it, I don't believe it, it's on an angle, you've artificially inflated it ahead of time, and anyone that falls for one deserves all the disappointment of trying to match it to reality. These polls are absolute rubbish, Andy. I read one the other day that said the plumbing in London was good, and it absolutely is not. I mean, what, we have this technology now where they can spy on my every bowel movement. There's a CTOS camera installed inside my underwear drawer. A media drone is scaring the birds off my garden bird feeder, and you can't get me consistently hot water.
Speaking of media drones, I mean, they're everywhere, clearly. The great thing, I guess, about media drones is that...
Auto drive now disabled.
They have more humanity, compassion and dignity than the human journalists we used to have to put up with a much more accurately calibrated moral compass. But it's the intrusion I can't stand, Alice. I mean, showbiz! Look at me here in this windowless dungeon.
Fuck. This place is full of Kelly pricks. How did they get so big?
You're looking for a terminal or some kind of device that Clan Kelly would have stored the debt records on. Don't have the right tool for the job? You can exchange your gadget for a different one that's better suited to the situation. While the drones observing your every move might make you feel like you're living in a city-shaped prison, what's bad news for society is good news for DedSec. You can hack those nosy little buggers and use them to scout ahead.
Oh, no.
going to raise all record of their debt, pushing our new friend back into the black, and more importantly, out of Clan Kelly's reach.
Fantastic.
Transfer complete. Cannabis and fentanyl together at last through the miracle of genetics.
It's true. Science makes everything possible now. Your debt to Clan Kelly is gone. Congratulations. You are free agent now. You no longer have to be their slave.
Wait a minute. You don't see my terrorists at all. Did the state-controlled media lie to me? But seriously, thank you.
You seem tough, like a fighter. We like this in Denzi. You want to join?
Yeah, all right. Fuck it.
There are none. There are no shortages of medicine. Don't take it.
Me.
DedSec resurgence have prompted Parliament to approve the use of lethal force for Albion contractors. CEO Nigel Cass had this to say.
DedSec terrorists will quickly find that Albion, unlike the police force of this city, is battle-tested and proven in the field.
The Prime Minister's office has called this shoot-to-kill mandate a drastic but necessary
fuck those assholes. Here, new optic.
Guess this is the moment of truth, yeah? Feels like signing up means kissing my normal life goodbye.
What's normal? You mean the one with government bricks shooting people dead?
Yeah, I know it's a hellscape. I'm not blind to that. Just let me say goodbye to everything I care about.
Look, you're not leaving anything. You just have to fix something so what you really care about is safe.
Yeah. You're right. Let's go.
Welcome to the Resistance.
Right. Welcome aboard, etc., etc. I'll give you the speech later. Right now, we need you and your big, strong drone friend to get on top of SIRS HQ and steal a server. Think you can handle that?
Right. Going now. All right, we're here.
I'll highlight the server with the AR reconstruction software. It's out of reach, so you'll need to use a heavy cargo drone to steal it.
All right, server's loaded up. I suppose you got it from here. Oh, and, don't blow up.
I get the feeling Bagley is a bad influence. Adios.
Data reconstruction in progress.
This will do. Remain in the area until I've downloaded enough data to the server. Download complete. I need a wider sample of data, so I'm pushing you the coordinates to a new location. ITOS drones, civilian optics, CCTV, and then it assembles those scraps into what happened in this location 24 hours ago. Fantastic.
Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled. Drive now enabled.
CTOS AR. Data reconstruction in progress.
All right. Scraping data from optics, CTOS cameras, microphones, laptops. Say, do you reckon SARS uses this to watch people shag? Fucking hell. Do they use it for anything but watching people shag?
I believe we're in trouble, Bagley.
Well, shit. Can you do anything to lose your new friends? Maybe invite them to a pottery night or overshare something personal. Whatever you do, just get to the last location in one piece.
Oh, for Christ... All right.
Transfer complete. I'm missing one last data set. Pushing you the coordinates to the location now. It's taking too much damage. A few more hits and it's toast.
Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled.
CTOS AR. Data reconstruction in progress.
We are inbound. Stand by.
These bloody drones seem to fancy me.
Don't let the drones destroy the server before I'm done. Get out of the lorry and take care of them. Shoot them. Throw rocks at them. Destroy them psychologically with cyberbullying. Just keep them busy until the transfer's complete. This server forever. We should probably wipe our prints off it anyway.
Keep talking.
I'll overload the CPUs to cause a power spike and destroy the battery unit. The electromagnetic pulse should destroy both the server and the drones. So, you know, run! Pulled up a heist, made life a bit harder for the tyrants of the world, and most importantly, I got a new toy to play with. Now, run along back to the safe house. Sabine wants you and your new teammates for a briefing.
All units, we have reports of a hostile in your area, over. Understood, Control. Awaiting further instruction, over.
Auto-drive now enabled.
Control, we're pursuing the suspect.
Control, target is unarmed from checkpoint.
Well done, team. It's good to see the safe house filling up again. The only way we're going to keep London from falling into total oppression is by rebuilding the resistance. We need to recruit, train, build back our arsenal. The people are itching to rise up and take their city back. We just need to show them that DedSec are fighting along with them.
Listen, as long as we put a stop to people exploiting the city, I'll be happy.
The constant Albion beatdowns aren't making me feel any safer. But I bet they're making money.
Clan Kelly are also bad guys. Exploiting people who are weak? We kill them too.
Fair, but remember that this zero-day hacker group is still out there. They took out DedSec once, and it's a good bet they'll try again. I believe they were responsible for the bombings and framed DedSec. With your help, I plan to get to the bottom of this mystery.
I'd say that's a full docket. Enough talk. Let's unfuck London.
A lead that may help us unravel more about Zero Day and the bombings we ate shit for. I've picked up an encrypted signal from the Tone conference site that's been broadcasting on a loop since the night of the bombing. Go investigate. You might even get to try out that fancy new AR tech we stole. I mean, creatively shared.
Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled.
Being so excited for the Tone conference. Being here now, it's like walking through a tomb.
Yeah, so why does it look like the bad guy's lair for the spy film? I'm just saying there's a lot of security for a repair job.
Well, when you put it that way, let's get this done, Bagley. What am I looking for?
Any kind of device or component that could still be emitting the signal. It seems to be coming from within the rubble.
looking to automate our jobs, mate. This is no joke. Director Cass. You're serious? Who told you that?
Friend over in R&D. The shit he's told me about background checks and knowing who's going to be useful to Albion, who's going to be a problem.
You that worried about your job? This is a PMC. They already do background checks on all of us.
Oh, you don't get it. He was talking about the general population, not just us employees. How bad is it that everyone has to be watched that closely?
Well, look around. It's fucking bad. And Cass is going to do what he has to keep it from getting worse. Suggest you do the same.
signal is coming from this spider-bot fragment. No indication yet who it belongs to.
I'm amazed this hunk of junk is even operating. What's it doing here?
Difficult to say, but with an AR reconstruction, we may be able to see what happened to it and if it relates to the attack. Access data relays in the vicinity, and I can compile enough data to build the AR reconstruction. Perfect. Two more data relays to go. do it. Now, I'll just take the audio from this stream and the video from these 36 and... Got it. Go back to where you found that spider bot, and I'll show you the AR reconstruction from the night of the explosion.
Got it.
Data reconstruction in progress.
You brought the payload?
What, think we'd go back here?
Don't trust the Kelly dog.
Kelly dog. Clan Kelly. Those dirty mobsters did the bombings.
It was not their operation, but looks like Clan Kelly was supplier.
What are the odds that this is a member of Zero Day? They certainly aren't with the Kellys.
Well, don't just stand there. Keep looking.